LeBrider gets brutal lesson on what happens in Texas when you try to blow up patriotic monuments. Liberals around the country have taken the lax punishment for the recent riots as a free pass to do whatever they want and brand it social protesting. This can be seen in the way they're showing their disrespect by attempting to destroy monuments, attacking anyone they suspect of holding different political beliefs and seeming to think that it's their right. It's unclear where they believe the right to act in violence came from, but much of the country is left feeling powerless to stop it. Certain cities in the South have been specifically targeted because of the history of slave owners and their fight in the Civil War. The push to erase this part of history is in hyperdrive and it's making a lot of headway. Those who are more than willing to break the law tend to get more done than the law-abiding citizens who don't want to see public property destroyed. Because the monuments in the South are being defaced and destroyed at a disturbing pace over the last few weeks, security has been heightened, and a watchful eye is being kept. That came in handy when authorities saw something fishy going on at a monument in Houston. Apparently, Spring Branch native Andrew Schenek wanted to take justice into his own hands but forgot that he was in Texas, where that is frowned upon. The 25-year-old, who still lives with his parents, was found with explosives, about to take out the Dick Dowling statue when police intervened. Apparently he didn't like the guy and that's why he was about to bomb a national monument. Specific information about this crime was found on CRN. Andrew Schenek, who was charged with trying to bomb the Dick Dowling statue, shown in his 2009 junior year Memorial High School yearbook in Spring Branch ISD. The park ranger spotted him kneeling in the bushes by the 112-year-old Confederate statue, explosives in hand. "Was he trying to harm the statue?" she asked. "Yes," he said. "He didn't like the guy." The late-night confrontation at the statue of Confederate Lieutenant Dick Dowling, detailed in court records by a federal agent, led to the arrest of 25-year-old Andrew Schenek, setting off a two-day operation by law enforcement that forced the evacuation of the Tony Rice University neighborhood where Schenek lives with his parents. Bomb squad experts detonated a cache of high-powered explosives found on the property Monday afternoon as residents waited to return to their homes. The arrest marked the latest chapter in a growing fight over Confederate statues that has sparked protests across the country, punctuated by a deadly clash between white supremacists and counter-protesters August 12 in Charlottesville, Virginia. Schenek, charged Monday with attempting to maliciously damage or destroy property, was ordered into federal custody pending a court hearing later this week. If convicted, he could face up to 40 years in prison and a $250,000 fine. It is the second time Schenek has run afoul of federal law enforcement. He was convicted in 2014 of storing explosives at another of his parents' properties and sentenced to 5 years probation, but was released early last year. Lawyers for Schenek offered few details about the case. "This is an evolving situation, with an ongoing investigation," said Philip Hilder, who is representing Schenek and who represented him in the previous case. "It would be premature to comment at this time since we have not seen the evidence." Schneck's arrest about 11 p.m. the Saturday followed a day of protests and counter-protests over another controversial statue, the Spirit of the Confederacy, in Sam Houston Park. The Destroy the Confederacy protest drew hundreds but ended without incident. Park Ranger Tamara Curtis, who was not allowed to speak to the media Monday, found Schenek near the base of the Dowling statue with two boxes filled with a homemade detonator, a timer, wiring, a battery, a bottle of nitroglycerin and an explosive organic compound known as HMTD, hexamethylene triperoxide diamine, according to the sworn statement by Federal Bureau of Investigations Special Agent Patrick Hutchinson. "I could be wrong, but I think when you cause the feds to swarm your parents' home, your TV privileges get suspended indefinitely. Especially if it's not your first offense. This particular overgrown adolescent is somewhat in luck though. It's not guaranteed that you'll be treated gently if you're caught with explosives, ready to destroy public property in Texas." In light of the recent misconduct of rioters, Texas enacted a measure to try and discourage this kind of activity. Freedom Daily reported on that just days ago. Now a Texas cop who works as a firearms instructor is putting protesting snowflakes across America on notice, informing them that if they're caught destroying a monument, they'll more than likely end up dead. He reveals that under Texas law, any citizen can use deadly force to stop vandalism. Officer Phil Ryan recently took to social media, warning Antifa, BLM, or anyone who thinks they're ballsy enough to bring anti-American antics to Texas, that their little plan could cost them their lives. Lucky for this kid, he wasn't found by Officer Ryan. However, it's likely that if the left keeps this madness up, at some point one of them will be caught by an equally pissed off Texan. But hey, they've been put on notice, what else can we do? Thank you for watching this video. What do you think about this? Share this on Facebook and Twitter along with your comments.